Hey guys, welcome back. And today we're going to talk all about design style and how to figure out or how to determine maybe what your design style is. We're going to jump right in here. So I'm super excited to talk about this with you guys today because it's a frequently asked question, believe me. To jump right in, what we've got is three main categories that all the other styles of the day kind of sit underneath, which is there's contemporary, which everybody's familiar with, there's transitional, and then there's traditional, okay? Those are kind of the super categories. So we're gonna kind of look at a few today. Scandinavian, mid-century, rustic, farmhouse, industrial, coastal or sort of a beach idea, eclectic, boho, and completely traditional. So we're talking about all of those today. Minimalism, if you think about it, is a really stripped version of contemporary, but with even less activity, furnishings, and even decor. Clean lines, simple forms, bare walls, spare furnishings, usually with only one single visual pop in the entire space. These spaces are often monochromatic and they're only usually found in warm and cool neutrals. So in reality, minimalism makes for beautiful photography. But to be honest, life is kind of messy. So we might want to like bump it up just a hair. So another one that is sort of sitting on that end of the spectrum with minimalism, but isn't quite as restrained, is the Scandinavian style. And this has gotten a really big resurgence lately, so it's nice to see some fresh takes on things. It's still contemporary and clean, but it emphasizes more comfortable, light, bright, lots of natural materials, clean, recessive in nature, but with kind of a coziness. There's lots of natural finished woods and cotton, wool and fur, and a lot of emphasis on bringing the natural world in other ways, like with plants. If you have a black thumb like I do, you definitely want to skip this one. So another contemporary style that I would typify by the word fun, it may be something that you guys really recognize and resonate with, is mid-century modern. It really typifies a very specific area of time, late 40s, 48, 49, all the way through to late 60s. And then we started to move into different and far uglier things, let me tell you. And when you think about what was happening in the world, there was the space race, ideas about what the future could be like. And so it's really kind of fun. It's got a more playful, futuristic expression, and it'll often have a particular color scheme. Kind of uses sort of those specific greens kind of on the yellowish green side, like an avocado, earth tones. As it got a little bit later, there might even be a little pop of kind of a primary color because primaries of blue, red, and yellow were really, really hip. Splayed legs on chairs. There's literally a light fixture which I adore called the Sputnik, which kind of reflects the concept of that earlier space travel and things, and a lot of asymmetry. It sort of goes, let's make this wall a little bit heavier on one side, or let's make the side of the fireplace more of a massing statement than the center. And there's a lot of it out there, so it may really resonate a lot with you. So another style that I really love, kind of a rustic contemporary style. And this I see a lot in ski lodges and mountain retreats, cabin areas, and it's a subcategory of contemporary, but it's got a little bit of a twist. I'll show you what I mean. You can see that in these spaces you have a contemporary architectural envelope, but they've been completely rendered in sort of rustic materials. Those are things like reclaimed and unfinished woods, lots of natural stone, distressed materials, both in metals and in textiles. You can even have distressed plaster, or that's a big one. There's usually a lot of glass because a lot of times this style is done in spaces where there's scenic views. It feels warm, it feels inviting, lots of big kind of chunky stone fireplaces and expressed beams, lots of leather, more masculine, a little bit more rustic, not as light and bright, but definitely emphasizes distressed and reclaimed materials. So we're sort of popping out of contemporary and sort of moving into that next super category, farmhouse. This is the style du jour, and I'm sure you're gonna recognize this if you have a Pinterest page or anything. Farmhouse was really a contemporary take on rural architectural elements and detail. It's almost exclusively rendered in black and white, and it features a lot of black steel windows. Also, kind of a cottage vibe to it, sort of vintage 19th century furnishings that have been redone, so there's a lot of upcycling that happens with that, and certainly you can do a lot of DIY with things. It has a very specific clean look to things, and it feels very fresh. So another style that I'm getting a lot of requests for, or I have over the last couple of years, is industrial. It's definitely an urban statement, and it has a little bit of a masculine vibe to it. It works well in a lot of spaces that are in cities. There's a lot of loft conditions, you know, in New York and in San Francisco areas. It's an expression of 19th century sort of industrial revolution. So we were getting very enchanted by machines and trains and everything, you know, motors and all the rest of that. There's a lot of materials used are things like brick, concrete, glass, steel, iron, big, leather, raw or unfinished materials. There was also a lot of fascination with mechanical details. So say like coffee tables with kind of factory wheels on the base of them, grazed natural woods and deep saturated tones of like blue, grays, all kinds of the huge range of grays into charcoal. Natural leathers were a big color. If you're liking the style but don't want to go wholeheartedly that dark, you can mix and match a little bit with this one. But it's all about those textures, which is a very different feel for a lot of people. Okay, so I know you guys probably know that I'm in California, but I do a lot of work all over. But I do get a lot of requests for this next style, which is coastal and beach. They're not really so much about architectural statements. Coastal and beach is really a decor statement because you can have a contemporary space or a traditional space, and you can still make it feel very coastal. Just directing what you use in terms of finishes, colors, furnishings, and your decor. You want to bring that statement of nature inside, but you do it in a very specific way. Take a look at these. The overall experience is sun-soaked, it's soft, it's casual, and it's definitely using natural elements. Colors mimic the environment, and ranges of whites and light shell colors, blues, sands, and soft tones being predominant. Lots of soft materials, cottons, lightweight gauzy sheer draperies, jutes, natural woods. You know, you could even do this island vibey, or you can take it a little bit more classical into kind of a traditional navy and white vibe, sailor beach or sailor coastal. A lot of that's very popular on the east coast of the US, but you know, on the west coast, they tend to do it a little bit more casually. You know, when you're at the beach or when you're living in a beach environment, you spend most of your time outside. A lot of surfboards get mounted on walls, those kinds of things. That might be something that really resonates for you, but you may be living, and I don't know, in Chicago. But that doesn't mean you can't spin coastal the way you want to. So this next category that I'm going to talk about, you can have an eclectic vibe that mixes a couple of styles, but it tends to involve the function of the space. It's usually found in a space with a theme to it, such as travel, sports, music, or other specific interests. Dedicated rooms such as libraries, studies, man caves, entertainment dens often can take on an eclectic feel. Perhaps a large piano, bookcases, maybe you're an art collector, or even a travel memorabilia area. It tends to have a feel that may mix with the overall taste of your home, but it has a specific condition that's being served by the space. So if you're working with a space like this, check out this video here and it'll talk about how to declutter. That'll really help you in terms of refining the space and still represent some of the style that you've got reflected in the rest of your home. This last one that we're talking about is the super category of traditional. And I'm sure this is going to be easily recognizable for everybody because there's a lot of buildings throughout the planet that have been built before the 20th century, and they will all contain elements of traditional, but many different styles. It's a huge category. You can think about things like Victorian, you can think about Tuscan style, vintage cottage style, Versailles Palace in France. That's traditional. And that really takes it to another level. And I throw Bohemian into the traditional category because it combines a lot of traditional elements, but in a very sort of sexy, fresh way. It's got some of those traditional elements, right? Intricate detailing, rich colors. But instead of one or two layers of pattern and texture, it has a lot. Think Turkish brass pendants that have multicolored glass in them, heavily embroidered Indian and velvet textiles, deeply colored walls, multiple patterned area rugs kind of layered on top of each other in the same spaces, many layers of decor items, all within the same space. Now, let me just say this. The Bohemian style is not for everybody. For one thing, it has an element of clutter. Now, that clutter is rather intentional, but if you're more of a person who wants to really kind of live in a cleaner space or a more organized space, this is definitely not you. But it is very rich, it's sexy, it's got a lot of interaction with it, and there's a lot of interest in it. If you're gonna try and relate to some of those things, make one or two things push yourself over the edge. Like maybe combine like five patterns of pillows or something on your sofa. And that will really make a big statement. And that can be maybe enough with, say, a richly colored wall. Boom, you're done. That's the level of Bohemian that you're gonna feel comfortable with, because it's all about what works for you. One trick I've used with clients is I have them create a lookbook, usually in Pinterest, because that's the easiest way. And they put together just imagery that really represents what resonates for them. And then what we do is we look at it and go, so where kind of does this feel like it lives? Does this feel kind of Scandinavian, or maybe it feels a little bit more industrial? After you've done your lookbook, make sure that what that looks like really represents who you are and what you treasure about your life and how that's reflected in your space. Because really, that's what it's all about at the end of the day. I hope you've liked today's video. Please ask me questions down below. I always love answering your comments. They are so great. And be sure to stay safe, ring the bell, like, share, subscribe, please. And I'll see you next week.